Alright, what's going on, ladies and gentlemen? My name is Chris Gaming, and welcome to more Black Ops Cold War. In today's video, we'll go through everything that was shown in the Black Ops Cold War multiplayer reveal stream, and let me tell you, there are some exciting things. And if you guys are excited for Black Ops Cold War, and anytime enjoyed this video, make sure to see for the like button. For everything Call of Duty, make sure to subscribe, turn on the notification bell, and join the notification squad. And let's get right into it. And let's kick off this video with the returning gunsmith. Yes, you heard that correctly. It is back, and let me tell you, it's amazing. And why do I say that? Well, because each primary weapon will have 54 different attachments that you can select from. Not only that, just like Modern Warfare, you can select up to 5 attachments per weapon. However, the crazy part is, if you use a wild card, then you can go from 5 attachments on your weapons all the way up to 8 attachments on your weapons. And if that isn't amazing, then I don't know where it is, to be honest. The gunsmith in Black Ops Cold War is like Modern Warfare's one, but 10 times better. And if you thought what I just said that was it, no, wait, there is more. Alongside that, your secondaries can also have up to 5 attachments. And my personal favorite feature that has been added in the gunsmith is that now it shows you the advantages and disadvantages of using certain attachments in numbers instead of just a plus and a minus symbol like we had in Modern Warfare. For example, if you add a red dot sight, it will tell you that it adds plus 10 to your range, or if you are using a sniper scope, it will tell you that it will add plus 30 to your range, and that will come in handy when you are making your OP weapon. And I know some of you guys will say that's not a big deal, but when you come to think of it, it's actually a massive addition, because now you know exactly what is getting increased and what is getting decreased and by how much, and like I said, that is very, very important. Now let's move on to the score streak system, and it has been changed drastically, and let me tell you how. In the past 2 decades, when you went on a streak and you got killed, you lose all your progress and you start all over again. Well, that is no longer the case in Black Ops Cold War. Earned score no longer resets after death, so even after you die, your score will stay the same as it was, and you can continue exactly from where you left off. Which means going on streaks and getting the Bloodthirsties or the Mercilesses means pretty much nothing anymore, other than it gives you bonus score so you can earn score streaks faster. And to be honest, I'm not a big fan of that, because it makes dying in Black Ops Cold War not mean much anymore. Even if you die, you won't lose your progress and start all over again, and I know that that's a good thing, but then again, why fix something that's not broken? Due to the change, score streaks now have a cooldown time, so they cannot be spammed. And what that means is, because like I said, they don't reset after death anymore, players could just spam UAVs, counter UAVs, chopper gunners, etc. So to stop that, they introduced a cooldown timer where you cannot use any streaks that you've earned for that cooldown period. Like I said, I'm not the biggest fan of this change, but we need to play the game and test it out before we can make our final judgment, and who knows, maybe it will be the best feature they have ever introduced in Call of Duty. Now let's move on, and for the first time in the Black Ops series, we will have field upgrades. Obviously, we had field upgrades in Modern Warfare, and in Black Ops Cold War, they will work exactly the same with a cooldown period, and also they will last after death. In the Black Ops Cold War multiplayer reveal stream, we got confirmation on some returning game modes alongside some new ones. The returning game modes we have are TDM, Kill Confirmed, Domination, Search and Destroy, and all the game modes that we know and love. But alongside those, we also have some new ones such as Combined Arms, which is 12v12 domination with up to 6 capture zones. Yes, that's gonna be crazy. And to win, you need 400 points. Yes, you heard that right, 400 points. Combined Arms was showcased in the reveal stream with all the big YouTubers playing it on the map with the 2 ships in the Atlantic Ocean. We will get into that later on. But alongside your usual boots on the ground fighting, depending on the map you are playing this game mode on, you can use tanks, snowmobiles, and even attack helicopters. That will be amazing. We also have a new mode called Fire Teams, and the description says, Fire Team is a new 40-player category of Black Ops Cold War multiplayer, which has a game mode called Dirty Bomb. Now, they didn't say much about Fireteam. The only thing they said is that it will be 40 players with 10 teams of 4, but other than that, they haven't announced anything yet, but they said that we will learn more about this mode as we get closer to launch. And of course, we already knew about the VIP Escort mode because it was in the leaked gameplay from a couple of days ago, and luckily, the downed system that we saw in that gameplay is exclusive to only the VIP Escort game mode and won't feature in any other modes. Next up, we have the confirmed maps, and the multiplayer reveal, we ended up seeing 5 maps, but of course, at launch, there will be more than just 5. First of all, we have Armada, which is the 2 ships in the middle of the North Atlantic Ocean. That map's looking alright, I'm not gonna lie. You can even rappel up and down, and from ship to ship, it's looking beautiful. We also have Crossroads, which is the snowy map that was set in Uzbekistan. We also have, of course, Miami. We already knew about this. The night map in Miami with all the neon lights looking beautiful. We also have the Ural Mountains, which is set in Moscow. And we also saw the map Satellite, which is the desert map set in Angolia. And if you guys remember, we saw it in the 15-second multiplayer clip that we got after the campaign reveal. However, the one thing that I realized in all the maps that we got to see in the multiplayer reveal is that they all look huge, and I'm not gonna lie, that kind of scares me, because I hope we do not have a repeat of Modern Warfare and you have games going to the time limit instead of score limit. I'm just a bit scared of that, but hopefully that won't be the case. Towards the end of the multiplayer reveal trailer, we got confirmation that the beta will indeed start on the 8th of October on PS4 first, with Xbox and PC to follow a couple days later. And right at the very end of the multiplayer reveal trailer, we got a zombies teaser, and let me tell you, it looks darker and more scarier than ever. And one thing that I saw in that small teaser was that Monkey Bomb is actually returning to Black Ops Zombies. I'm not gonna lie to you guys, with every trailer that we are getting for Black Ops Cold War, it just makes me more and more excited, and I cannot wait to play this game. And right about now, my previous video should be on the screen. If you guys haven't seen it, make sure to go check it out. If you guys are excited for Black Ops Cold War and at any time enjoyed this video, make sure to see for the like button. For everything Call of Duty, make sure to subscribe, turn on the notification bell, and join the notification squad, and I'll catch you guys later.